Hey, welcome! In this class, I'm going to teach you how to morph between two PNG images in After Effects. I'll take you by hand and walk you through the entire process in a quick and fun way. We will take two PNG images, do some magic in After Effects, and be able to morph between them. This class is perfect for everyone wanting to learn a few things about tracing, placing effects, or working with masks. It will be easy to follow as I explain all the steps, but in case you fall into any trouble, I'm attaching all project files and you can post questions in the discussion board, I'll answer. Alright, ready to start and learn something new in After Effects? Let's go! In the first lesson, we will trace outlines for our images, and we will create masks we will use later for the actual morphing. I will open up Illustrator for a few seconds to show you something. If I have a PNG image like this, I have the head prepared. I place it inside of Illustrator. I come closer. You see, this is a rough edgy PNG low quality image. It has 500 pixels of size. There is a possibility in Illustrator to trace this image, use one of the presets or set it manually, and then expand the image to create a vectorized image which you can use. Something very similar is possible in After Effects, not as advanced, but we only need to trace the outlines of the actual images. I select both images, my PNG images are imported to After Effects. Let me start with the YouTube sign. I'll deselect the previous one, and I go to Layer, Auto Trace, and I'll stay with the basic options. You have to remember that you should apply this to a new layer. I press OK. And as you can notice, a new auto trace layer has appeared and the layer has the outlines exactly traced. So now we do not only have the PNG image, we also have a vectorized path. This is a mask and it's called mask 1. Let me maybe rename it. I hit enter and call it YouTube sign. I select the mask, control C. I press on the YouTube sign and I control V, paste it into both those PNGs. I select those PNGs and I press M to reveal the masks. I change its mode to add and here to none, because on the head, the YouTube sign is only to help us. Now I can delete the auto traced icon and do the same for the head. Let me click on the head, make it visible. By having it selected, go to layer, auto trace and do the same. I have now traced the head. I press M here. I rename it to head mask or as you want. Click on the head mask. Click on the YouTube sign. Control V. This is the head mask. It should be set to none because I only want to see the head on this sign. And here the opposite. I paste it. I place it maybe at the first so it's easier. And here I press add. All right, I'm prepared. So what did I do? On the YouTube sign, I have the sign outline to add and the head which we'll morph into is set to none because I only want to see those outlines. On the head PNG, it's the other way around. The head mask is set to add while the YouTube sign mask is set to none because this is only our reference point which we need to see once we click on it and we will later use in the effect. This is it. When it comes to the first part of what you need to do to morph between two PNG images. Now, if you didn't have any troubles and you are in the same place, please continue with the next lesson and we will get the work done. I'll also show you a useful effect which might help you when you are working with small PNG images in the future. In the second lesson, we will perform our morphing on the YouTube sign. We will prepare the sign, we will work with the mask and use the effect we need to achieve our morphing. Now we can start with the first one. Let's start by morphing the YouTube sign. And the thing that allows us to morph PNG images is actually an effect. I have forgotten about one thing, I should delete those keyframes, but we can also do this later. I hit the YouTube sign, I press M, and I just deselect the keyframes. Deselect it like this, I click on the YouTube sign, and I go to the effect we need. It's called reshape. It's also available, of course, in CS6. So I just drag this reshape effect and I tell this effect, Hello YouTube sign. My source mask is of course the YouTube sign, but in the destination we would like to morph to a hat mask. Now, what does this effect do? This effect, by moving the percentage, will morph automatically. You see, we are not quite there. This is because I should have a bigger PNG image. Since this is a very small image like this, it is limited by its barriers, by its actual size. But this is easy to overcome by adding another effect, which is called grow bounce. Grow bounce isn't a perfect effect, but for this PNG, it will work like a charm. I just make the bounce bigger, and basically it only grows me the size of the actual layer around here. Now you see this actual morphing here is very weird. What we can do to achieve better effects? At first, we can add more reference points. You see those correspondence points? If I open it, number of points, number of pairs actually is only one. And this point is morphing here far to the right. I should place it somewhere here. I should alt-click to add new points and just click. This will add new reference points. And remember that once we will do the head morphing, because we need to do this twice, one for the first morphing and one for the second morphing, those reference points should be similar because else will grow outside those bounds. So let me make this as simple as possible. I alt-click also here. If you are on a Mac, it's option, and maybe here, and that's enough. This is completely enough for my morphing. I set the keyframe at the beginning, at 0%, and going maybe 2 seconds forward, I want it to be morphed 100%. What else can we do to make it a bit more precise? You see this elasticity option. This option determines how fluid the actual animation will be performed. You see, this is a bit stiff. We have very rough edges here. By making the elasticity to absolutely normal, it will round the corners. For example, you can go even deeper to loose, it will make it even rounder. It all depends of what you want to achieve and what style you are aiming for. You can see this morphing is pretty good now. I can go on and make the same on the head. So remember, the more reference points you use, it will probably make the animation better and better. But since these are only simple PNG images, and we just want a fast morphing between them, you don't have to be really pixel perfect. A few reference points will be totally okay, because you want to finish this project today. Thank you very much for your attention. Let's go to the next lesson, where we will crunch on the head, and then we will try to fade both images, so it will create a seamless experience. In this lesson, we will work with the head. We will try to connect what we did until now, and we will fade between those two images to complete the morphing. Let us select the head PNG layer and find the effect we need. Please find reshape and place it into the layer. Here it's just the opposite, welcome reshape. My first shape is the head, of course, and we would like to morph into the YouTube sign. Is this possible? Yeah, of course, no problem. Okay. We have a little arrangement with the effect. Now, I once again place a keyframe at the percentage. I go 2 seconds forward. I morph it to 100%. Oh, let me deselect it and select this one to see what happens. The morphing is pretty good. It's not exact. It should be better done. I just want to make a quick approach here. I make it loose. I add just a few reference points by having this reshape selected. I press Alt. One was here, as I remember. One was here. One on this side. And this first one was here on the top. Now, the morphing is happening like this. The very last thing you need to do is to time reverse the keyframes of the second head, because at the moment, the circle is morphing into a head and the head is morphing to a circle. We want both to make the same at the same time. So I just press U on the head and I have the only keyframes I have here. I right click on them, keyframe assistant, time reverse keyframes. This is all you have to do now. I have both layers visible, both the YouTube sign and the head, and the morphing is performed. Now, depending on how good you made those reference points, the morphing should look alike. If you have small errors like this, this won't be visible. You can, for example, work with the opacity. So let me press the opacity on the head. I press T and I press T on the sign. Now I can work. I want the opacity on the YouTube sign to slowly resign as it starts to reveal the head. Maybe here it should hit 0%. While on the other hand, I want the head to first be invisible, and right at the end, before the 2 seconds, it should be visible. Now I can work with the keyframes a little bit, but basically this is how the morphing should be performed. Now I see this is an invisible spot. This shouldn't be like that. Maybe I place the keyframes like this. I shift this a bit to the right and preview it now. Well, too stiff again, like this, preview. Well, I haven't it perfect. I should extend those keyframes even more, even wider, but you get the idea. This is exactly how you can morph from one PNG image to another. Boom, boom. After Effects allows us to do so many creative things with video, but you can as well work with images and create something interesting like that. Thank you so much for finalizing this project with me, and you can continue now. We'll be right back.